And you can't help but notice the people that get in and out of the vehicles that are parked in the handicap zone.
Mike Dealey has reason to notice who's using handicap parking spaces. Just over 2 years ago, he was diagnosed with ALS, Lou Gehrig's disease. A few weeks ago, the disease forced him into a wheelchair.
It's only been 3 weeks, you know, and it was literally from a walker in 2 days to a chair.
With the help of his family, Mike is still getting around. But finding an open handicap parking space for his van can be challenging.
I've seen somebody at a local restaurant go ahead and use the handicap spot as the pickup window.
Mike's greater concern is drivers who are using handicap parking permits and they may not need them.
We do have the people that go ahead and maybe do or don't need a parking permit, but they choose to get it because it's easier for their life.
News 8 on Your Side checked with PennDOT and learned that more than 1.3 million handicap placards and license plates have been issued in Pennsylvania. To get one, you and your doctor have to fill out this form. If completed correctly, PennDOT tells us no application is rejected. Handicap parking placards can last 6 months or up to 5 years.
Handicap parking spaces like this in retail lots are almost always located on private property. But yet when it comes to enforcing the violations in these lots, that's done by local police departments. I checked with more than a half a dozen police departments in our area, and none of them tell me that they patrol lots like this looking for violators.
Tickets for handicap parking violations are most often issued on city streets, not in retail parking lots. In the first quarter of this year, Lancaster City has issued 210 tickets, generating $36,000 in fines. York issued approximately 190 tickets on city streets in the year 2018, and Lebanon issued 57 tickets for handicap violations in 2018. But in a private parking lot, Mike Dealey says he just has to hope that people will do the right thing.
If you do not belong in that parking spot, please do not take it.
I also check with the managers of 8 retailers throughout the Susquehanna Valley, retailers located in shopping centers. All of them told me they do not monitor their handicapped parking spaces for violations. If a customer complains about a possible violation, that customer is then advised to contact the police. So what we've learned here is that you're much more likely to get a ticket for parking in a handicapped spot on a city street than opposed to a retail parking lot because it's private property. And again, the police don't necessarily go looking for that. Mm-hmm. You've got to call and report the violation.
Maybe it's time to do some public service announcements.
You never know. I'll tell you what, this has already generated a lot of discussion on my Facebook page. Last I checked, there were dozens of comments on either side of this issue. So it's a volatile issue. There's no question about it.
Thank you, Brian.